Hi everyone, this is Nick, and I'm going to show you two really quick ways that you can convert tables that are in a PDF document over into Excel. So I have done this myself. I've seen other people do it where they have a hard copy of the PDF and they are manually typing in the data, the numbers, anything that's in those data tables in a PDF. And I'm here to tell you, you don't need to do that anymore. Let's just try a couple of these quick ways. They're not 100% perfect, but you're able to fix the errors as you go, and it's going to be a lot more quicker than typing everything manually. So right here on the screen, I have my PDF. I have two tables that are satisfaction survey scores. I have my Excel data or my Excel file open. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to import a picture into Excel, and it's going to convert everything into the data of this table. So what I want to do is I'm actually going to use my screen snipping tool. You can take a screenshot however you normally would take a screenshot, but I'm just going to screenshot this area right here of the table. I'm going to go back to my snipping tool and push on the copy button right there. That copies that picture, that screen grab, onto my clipboard. I'm going to go over to my Excel workbook, and we're going to go to the data tab right here. And then right over here, this drop down, it's going to say from picture. And I'm going to say from clipboard, since I copied that screenshot onto my clipboard. What it's going to do, it's going to do a little bit of working. It's going to tell me where that table, what that table looks like. And then over here in the right hand side, you get this data from picture tab here. You could just insert everything immediately, or you can look through, and Excel is kind of smart. It's telling me that all of these red cells, they're not exactly sure if we want to keep that data or we want to transform it. So right here, this top one, that's just the title of the table. I'm going to accept that. January, oh, it didn't quite get that whole month, so I'm going to accept that right there. This, it doesn't look like there's anything in that, so we're just going to accept it. And then that's kind of a blank cell that it's giving me. June and July, those look like they're good months, so I'm going to accept those data. Everything looks good. Now I'm going to select insert data. And once again, and there you go. Now we have that entire table here in my Excel workbook. Now, it's not quite perfect because you still see there's an empty column right here. We're going to go ahead and delete that. You just right click there. And then we probably don't need this one either, because actually the month, I'm just going to cut that and then paste it over here, and then we'll delete this column. But now I have a beautiful Excel table that I can work with and create charts, graphs, anything like that. That's way number one. Let's go with way number two. We're going to insert that data directly from the PDF. So let's go back to that data tab up here. Now, instead of the from picture, we're going to say this get data dropdown, and we're going to say from file. And then I'm going to say from PDF, and you're just going to point to that PDF wherever you saved it. I saved my PDF here, my demonstration PDF, on my desktop. We're just going to click on that, say import. It's going to do a little bit of thinking. It's going to tell me, okay, in this PDF document, it looks like there are a few different tables. Which ones do you want me to import? And I want them to import both. So I'm going to select multiple items and then say one and two. We're going to select both of those items. Now the thing is, they are actually going to import on separate workbooks, I believe, or separate worksheets, tabs in the workbook. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually select transform data here. And if you wanted to transform the data in this view, in this Power Query Editor, you could do that. You could kind of look through, change some values, make some calculations. We don't need to do that, so I'm just gonna say close and load. And once it does that, this query connections table is open. It's telling me these are the tables that I have. Here's my table on tab one right here, and here's my table on tab two down here. Now I'm going to have to do a little bit of manual work to get these tables together if I wanted them on the same worksheet or the same tab, but that saves you a lot of time than if you were just going through and typing everything one by one by one from a hard copy. So I hope you like these two methods. Remember, you can get some data from a picture into Excel from a PDF, or you can import tables directly from a PDF with that Get Data drop-down menu on the Data tab on the ribbon. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.